Hi, welcome to the channel. My name's Ash, and this is where we learn hacking and stuff together as friends. Today, we're going to be going over how to set up a new virtual machine with Kali Linux, and we're going to be using VirtualBox. So let's go ahead and look up VirtualBox under virtualbox.org. We can go ahead and download the latest version. So you just got to pick what operating system you have. So for me, Windows 64-bit, Mac OS, Intel based. They were dabbling with like ARM versions like M1, M2, M3, etc. I'm not sure what happened to that or any Linux distros. So you can go ahead and give that a download, follow the prompts, install. I trust you can do that. Next up, we want to go ahead and go to Kali Linux. There's actually a page on their website that's just get-kali. Bunch of different ways that we can download this. We're going to be using one of the pre-made virtual machines. So we can go ahead and click that. That's going to be taking us over to this pre-built VM section. The architecture, 32-bit or 64-bit. I'm 64-bit. So if you're using VMware, go ahead and do that. Hyper-V, QE, MU. VirtualBox is here, so we can go ahead and just download that. So the file size are all around 3 gigabytes. Just be aware it may take a little bit to download depending on your internet connection. In the odd case that there's a virus detection, you can try again. You can go ahead and right click the torrent link and get a link of that. If you're using the Brave browser, you can just go and paste that in. It uses WebTorrent, or you can just use whatever torrent client that you have. Apparently there is a Trojan, I guess kind of makes sense. There are a lot of tools, probably a Trojan, the part of the tools in the Linux suite. So generally speaking, we want to trust our antivirus. We kind of know that this is from a trusted source. So I'm just going to go and allow, I guess that's kind of why we had this virus detection earlier too. False positives. Not really. They are positive. They are Trojans, but they're not working against us. Once we finally have it, we can right click here, show more options, 7-zip, and just extract here. If you don't have 7-zip, you can just right click and use the extract all and then just select extract there. Great. Now we're going to see our extracted folder. So I'm just going to head remove that first one. And here we will see our VBox file, which is for VirtualBox to see, and a VDI, which is a virtual hard drive or disk image. So if you want to go ahead and make a copy of this, go for it. Otherwise, I'm just going to double click the VBox. That is then going to import this virtual machine. So that file had all the settings, and that's gone ahead and just imported it straight into our VirtualBox. So let's go ahead and go to settings. I just like to rename it Kali Rolling. It's going to be version 2. By default, some things are already going to be on, but I just like to check bi-directional to copy and paste, drag and drop between your host machine and your virtual machine. It's good that that's on. Checking the description, it's got our username and password already default. We can change that later. Going down to system, our base memory is set to 2 gigabyte. So you can see all in the green bar for your machine. That's all good to use. Just be careful going up to the orange and red. That's just how much RAM that your machine is allowing this virtual machine to use. So personally, I just like running like 6 or so. You can kind of like adjust that as you use your virtual machine over time. Same sort of thing for processor. I just like giving it a few cores, staying within that green area, playing it safe. Nothing to do in display. We can see here in storage is that VDI file that we saw earlier. So currently it is 13 gigabytes, the actual size. It can go all the way up to 80 gigabytes. Enable audio. I'm just going to check that off because I'm not going to be using audio on my VM. Checking over the network settings. Just one single adapter is in use. So NAT is just going to essentially share the same network adapter on my real computer, and that can get internet access. So that's the easy one to leave it as. Serial ports are fine. USB is fine. No shared folders, and the user interface we can just leave as is. All right, now with all of that set, we can just go start virtual machine. You can see our little preview is running, so I can go ahead and close down VirtualBox. Awesome. And our default is Kali and Kali. And there we go. We can resize our VM as big as we want, and we have scaling already enabled, so that's nice. And a good idea with a new installation is just run sudo apt update and sudo apt upgrade, dash Y for yes, and put in our pseudo password. Great, let it run its course, do its thing. That's pretty much it. You're good to go. In this case, there are no upgrades because this is the latest box. So that's awesome. If you want to get into cybersecurity and hacking, you're going to see a walkthrough to my latest room for Try Hack Me. Fantastic platform to learn. So you can go ahead and use your virtual machine in action on that room. Thank you very much. Okay, bye.